America and Greece have come together for several noble purposes, like democracy, in the ancient and modern worlds. Tonight, in Washington, D.C., we celebrate such a coming together at the annual Oxi Courage Awards. For the 11th year, we honor remarkable people from around the world who possess a rare courage, reminiscent of the courage displayed by the Greek people during World War II. As President Franklin Roosevelt said, the Greeks dared to question the invincibility of that German monster. And this year is quite special as we celebrate Greece's bicentennial, the 1776 inspired and American-supported revolution of 1821. It returned democracy and independence to Greece. Then U.S. President James Monroe told a joint session of Congress, "Greece fills the mind with the most exalted sentiments and sympathies in their favor throughout the United States." He was referencing the support for Greece by John Quincy Adams and the thousands across America who raised funds to aid Greece fighting for their independence. As a result of this bond between our countries, the founder of the modern Greek state described their new constitution by saying to America, "In imitating you, we shall imitate our ancestors and be thought worthy of them if we succeed in resembling you." We see our Courage Awards today as part of that enduring bond and a celebration of the 200th anniversary of Greek independence. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, for a special greeting from Greece on Oxi Day, the Prime Minister of the Hellenic Republic, Kyriakos Mitsotakis.
Please welcome, for a greeting from the government of Greece, the Ambassador of Greece to the United States, Alexandra Papadopoulou.
Good evening. Today, we commemorate one of Greece's most courageous moments in its modern history, when the Greek people, showing extraordinary courage, opted to stand up to fascism and totalitarianism in a struggle between unequals, and in which the underdog finally prevailed. Tonight's event, as so much in life, is about courage. Plato explains the courage as the ability to persevere through emotions such as fear, suffering, pain, and danger. What helps people go through these fears and persevere? It's their belief in something much bigger than themselves. You have the courage to stand up to injustices, fascism, pain, persecution, only if you believe, when you believe, in something much bigger than what you are. When you have fear in God, love of country, love of family, love of your fellow human beings. Greeks, back in 1940, when they said no to fascism and totalitarianism, they also said yes. They said yes to a better life. They said yes to the lights that was coming at the end of the tunnel, because they believed in themselves. All of us in Greece have stories of courage and stories of suffering from those dark days. Personally, my father, who was a young cadet at the Greek military school, was taken at 20 years old to fight in the Battle of Crete. And he was taken prisoner of war, and he spent the following years in conditions that nobody wants to think about. Nevertheless, after he became a free man again, and when Greece started standing on its own feet, he never spoke about those days. He never said about a bad word about those who captured and tortured him. Every time we were asking him, he was shrugging his shoulders and say, "That's the war." And his only wish, the one he fought for the rest of his life, was that his children live in a better world, in a world where there is no darkness and there is no fear. And this is what Greece stands for today. And we managed to get 2,000 years of hardship behind us, to live in a European Union which stands for reconciliation, for understanding, for love of each other and for tolerance. Today's recipients, award recipients, have shown that they know how to fight for what they believe in. I don't have words to speak about the Ecumenical Patriarch, one of the most preeminent leaders of our world, and whom we had the honor to have with us these past days in Washington. And of course, Mr. Alcantara, who is a very well-known fighter for human rights and dignity in his own country. But you will allow me to have some special words for the lady among us, Mrs. Kafari. Not only because Afghanistan and Greece share a long history of close traditions dating back to Alexander the Great, but also as a woman, I feel very strongly about women's rights around the world, and I want to assure her that the human rights in her country and the women's rights in her country are close to the heart of all women around us, Greek women above everything else. The Prime Minister of Greece, whose family has also suffered during the war, and his father was the leader of resistance in the native island of Crete and was sentenced to death, and he managed to escape the last moment, also tries to give this message to the younger people today, that let's forget about what divides us, let's stand for what unites us, but we should never forget. We should forgive and we should not forget, because the forces of darkness are around us. They will always be around us, and it's up to us to fight them off. His message was supposed to be videotaped. Unfortunately, logistical reasons didn't allow that to happen, so I will read it to you. To the Washington Oxi Day Foundation. It is now 81 years since the Greek people wrote one of the most illustrious chapters in their modern history. The passage of time does not, however, diminish the importance of Oxi Day. Greeks around the globe rightly celebrate the anniversary of the No, Oxi, because it symbolizes the importance of a fight for freedom fought yesterday to preserve the freedoms we enjoy today. On October 28, 1940, we stood up to the forces of darkness, sweeping across Europe, and offered the free world their first sign of hope, and a belief that liberty and dignity would prevail. Perhaps the fascists should have known better than to take us on. After all, we Greeks have a durable legacy of resistance and resilience that spans thousands of years, storied in battle, from Marathon to Thermopylae, from Thermopylae to Salamis, victory or defeat. Greeks have fought ferociously to preserve the values and freedoms they hold so dear. Greece, the birthplace of democracy, has often been at the forefront of both European and global evolution and struggle. This year we celebrate the 200th anniversary of the Greek War of Independence, a war won against all odds, a war that inspired others to break free from the shackles of empire, a war that made Greece the first nation state in Europe. In choosing to send a resounding Oxi to Mussolini in the winter of 1940-41, Greece deliberately put itself in the vanguard of resistance to the Axis powers and stood firm against fascism and totalitarianism. In doing so, we became the first country to take the fight back to the enemy on European soil. As FDR has said at this time, Greece has set the example that every one of us must follow until the despoilers of freedom everywhere have been brought to their just doom. Our country, on the same side as the United States in all modern conflicts, continues to honor that legacy of resistance and will always stand by others when faced with totalitarianism and oppression. This year marks the 11th anniversary of the Oxi Courage and Service Awards. I would like to congratulate the Oxi Day Foundation for honoring the resilience and achievement of the Greek people in the Second World War by recognizing the efforts of those modern-day heroes who continue to fight for freedom, equality, and human rights. I would also like to congratulate tonight's honorees who embody the spirit of Oxi Day, placing themselves, as they do, in the front line of some of the biggest challenges of our age. Firstly, I would like to extend my warm congratulations and utmost respect to His All Holiness Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew, the spiritual leader of more than 300 million Orthodox Christians worldwide, and a leading voice in the struggle to save our planet and to secure religious freedom and human rights. May I also take this opportunity to congratulate Luis Manuel Otero Alcantara of Cuba, named by Time magazine among the 100 most influential people of 2021. And finally, I would like to congratulate Afghanistan's first female and youngest ever mayor, Zarifa Gavari, a leading voice for the rights of women, not only in her own country, but around the world. I'm proud to say that Greece has recently welcomed a number of female judges and female members of parliament from Afghanistan, offering them assistance in fighting refugee, whether here in Greece or in other nations. The sacrifices they have made remind us that we all have a duty to stand up for freedom and stand together against oppression. Thank you and enjoy your evening together. Kyriakos Mitsotakis, Prime Minister. Thank you.